Now that you've mastered arrays, we are going to talk about something that a lot of people struggle with, but multiple dimensional arrays. And you just need to clear your mind, take a breath, and think of them as an Excel spreadsheet where you have rows and columns. Now, in this example, we create a two-dimensional array in Java of the average monthly temperature for Massachusetts. So what we have is the years going down the side. Now note, the year, this part is not part of the array, nor is this. This row, and this row is part of the array. So what we do is we have three rows and 12 columns that represent the 12 months. We also have some overloaded methods that help us work with these arrays. So, as usual, we have a class called Introduction to Multiple Arrays. We have a main, and we're using mains and console programs just to keep the concept simple. So right here, we declare a multiple dimensional array called iTemps1. And how we do that is we have one pair of square brackets for the number of rows and another pair of square brackets for the number of columns. So in this example, we have three rows and 12 columns. And we populate the data this way, where we say in the first row, in the first column, 34. The first row, second column, 37, so on and so forth. Then we move on to the next row, which is the second row, and 0 through 11, because remember, we have three rows and 12 columns, but we access them, the rows 0, 1, and 2, and the array, the second array dimension for the columns would go from 0 to 11. And here we have 2006 data. And I'm going to show you another way to declare an array. Again, we have the two pairs of square brackets, rows, columns, and this one's called iTemps2, and we put the data in this way. Here's the curly brace that marks the beginning of the array, and here is the ending of the array. Here's row 1, 2, and 3, and here's column 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. And what we do is we have a method called displayToScreen where we pass it in an entire array. Then we also have an overloaded version of the method that takes one particular integer. And again, we call the displayToScreen that takes the array and we pass in the second array. Let's go take a look at those methods. You can see right here in this method, we don't return anything. That's the void. It's called displayToScreen. We take an integer multiple dimensional array, one dimensions for the row, so we have three of them, and another dimension for the columns that go this way. We have a outer loop, very similar to our prime numbers, where we call it row, and we go to the length of the inner array that's passed in. And notice here on the inner loop, this is where we do the columns going this way, we go from 0 to less than the length of the inner, or the columns. And notice we take the array for the row we're on, dot length. And up here, we just do the dot length for the array. And we process out to the screen using the row and column. And in this particular method, we take one integer value, not array. All right, I hope you enjoyed this.